I don't know how it's possible, but I missed him my whole life, even though I never really knew him, because he died when I was two.
Faith Harriman was only a toddler when her father died, and soon afterward, a family member began abusing her.
The person would turn into just a fit of rage, really. It was very scary. Things like pinches on the arm that would just cause little bruises or something, to just having handfuls of hair pulled out, or being thrown into corners and, being kicked across an entire room almost.
She craved her father's love, but as she grew older, she simply just wanted a man to love her. She met someone when she was 15. He was 21. They began dating and moved in together, but after that, everything changed.
I lost my virginity, and then he left. And I thought that we'd had 2 years of that he loved me, and then he said, "You should just date other people. You're too young. See ya."
Faith decided that no one would ever hurt her again.
I broke up with people. I left people, and I realized I did everything I could do, looking back, to not ever have to be left.
But isolating herself didn't stop Faith's misery. She found a different way to numb her pain, and it started with alcohol.
And what turned into having a drink turned into smoking pot, and then that's kind of a gateway, and I ended up experimenting with drugs and just getting sucked into the wrong crowd.
Faith grew up going to church. She even prayed to become a Christian.
It just didn't stick. I would give my life back to God, or just decide I'm not going to drink anything anymore or anything like that. And it wouldn't last very long because I wasn't taking myself out of a situation. I felt like I left God. I think I was so disappointed with myself that I thought, of course, he was disappointed with me, that I should have been stronger.
Faith felt like God didn't accept her, so she started dating someone who did. He was the perfect man, or so she thought.
I kind of ran to him, and he ended up being really physically abusive, verbally abusive, really scaring me.
Sit down.
I was in a very fearful relationship, and I put up with stuff and forgave stuff that I never would have.
The two got engaged. Faith knew she shouldn't stay in the relationship, but she was too much in love to call it quits. Then she discovered she was pregnant.
I knew that I could make stupid decisions for my life, but for an innocent child, that she deserved the very best of everything I could do. So I just got on my face and cried out to God just to be there.
She knew she had to leave her fiancé.
I was crying out, going, "God, I'm going to marry this guy, but if he's going to ruin my life and this little girl's life, set us free." And so he showed me and gave me a clean conscience with leaving. And I took off with nowhere to go, pregnant.
Faith was alone, again. But this time, she decided to turn to God instead of a man.
I cried out broken, "If it's not even too late for my destiny, if I haven't ruined it, if you haven't given my assignment to somebody else, then use me."
Faith says that when she prayed that prayer, God changed her life completely. An old friend gave her somewhere to live, and she joined a church. Now, instead of looking to men for love, she looks to God.
The biggest part in the transition of giving my heart to God when I was pregnant was I learned my whole life in church to give him your heart. But at that point, he showed me that it was okay to give him my broken heart.
Today, her daughter Elise is 3 years old. Faith and Elise spent much of their time in Peru, where Faith ministers to abused and forgotten women.
I thought it was too late because I'd wasted years, or I thought it was too early because I wasn't old enough or holy enough or a virgin or married. I'm a single mom and a statistic to the world. Everything that you thought you lost or that the enemy stole as a child before you even had a say-so, that he can give you and fulfill all of those things. He can reawaken those dreams.